Pixie your brain, the big, giant, juicy tick on it. They take a second, the life-giving blood from your brain. You're starting to lose blood. You can't think straight, you can barely move. You're just not functioning normally anymore. Do you want the antidote to get rid of this tick? We would first start by removing it. In order to protect against any residual effects of the parasite, you would then take some antibiotics. Think of the tick as a negative thought because negative thoughts feed on your attention. The more you think about it, the more it's sucking you dry. The way to get rid of this thought would be first by removing the negative thought and then attaching a positive thought in order to cancel it out. Just like antibiotics, continued use of this action will increase the likelihood of that thought staying away. Now let me explain. We always have thoughts that make us feel down in some way, shape, or form. But just because a thought pops into your head doesn't mean you have to identify with it. Realize that we are our thoughts. We are whatever you want to be. So if you want to think that you want to be great, you're going to be great. If you want to think that you're going to be terrible, then you're going to be terrible. For example, before writing these notes, I went through this thought process right here. The bad thought or tick in this case would be, I'm not a good enough writer to make this video. Now I'm going to remove the tick and take an antibiotic pill by using this thought instead. Of course I'm a good enough writer. I've written plenty of great things in the past. I just need to stop thinking I can't and think I can. It's hard sometimes, but the only way to write is to do and not let the tick grow from prolonged attention. Now I'm gonna do a second example for that's more relatable to other people. Example two. The bad thought would be, I am ugly and nobody wants to date me. Now I'm gonna remove the tick and take the antibiotic pill by using this thought. I am good looking and plenty of people want to date me. Beauty is in the eye of the beholder, so nobody is ugly unless you want to be ugly. There are many factors that judge whether someone wants to be with me anyway, other than just beauty. Now, let me tell you the theory behind basically what this technique would be based on. Basically, we are invalidating the previous negative thought that was sucking up our attention with a different, more positive one that will boost confidence. Repeated use of this technique makes it more of an automatic response in your brain, causing you to function at a normal level. Basically, this works because the more you think a certain way, the more those neural pathways get strengthened. So the more you start thinking that you're like an actual good person and you're like confident, the more that you'll actually be confident because it's be automatic in your brain, vice versa for negative thoughts. Now, I'm gonna go through this step by step. First of all, you could do this for multiple thoughts at the same time, but I found in my experience that it works to just use this for one thought at a time. So second of all, you want to write this stuff down. I'd say write it down because it's better to you think things, write them down, and then saying them out loud. It helps for like get it closer into like more solidified in your brain. So write down the bad thought first. Think of the thought that would invalidate the negative thought and instead make it positive. Write this down as an affirmation. Basically, an affirmation is a positive statement declaring a specific goal in their completed state. So basically by saying like, let's say you want to be a firefighter. You'd say, I am a firefighter. That would be your affirmation. Another example would be, let's say you want to be confident. Let's say you're very like insecure about yourself. You'd say, I am confident. That would be another example of an affirmation. It'd be best used if you do this like every single day in the mornings, at night before you go to sleep or something like that. Keep saying that. And like I said before, it strengthens the neural pathways so that you'll be more likely to think that in the future. Now, after you write down this affirmation that to cancel out the negative thought, you would remember this new thought every single time the old thought pops into your mind. Basically, what we're doing when we write down the invalidation thought, that is you have to make sure that when you write that down, that it really like invalidates the previous thought so that you know that, okay, I'm really just dumb for like, I don't want to use that negative word, dumb, but like, it really doesn't make any sense for me to think this certain way. So every single time you think that thought that can be invalidated, you automatically have the response to invalidate it with the new thought. So the more you do that, the more like you just are automatically gonna be able to do that and you can start feeling better. So hope this is very useful to you in any way, shape, or form. Come back and subscribe, like, comment. I have more content like this in the future. Thanks.